At the state capitol, Senate panel today dropped most of the ethics complaints against a Minneapolis state senator. As John Cromer reports, Senator Omar Fateh won't receive any major sanctions over his 2020 campaign.
Two testifiers with two attorneys with them.
This was the fourth hearing by the Senate Ethics Subcommittee about Senator Omar Fateh's 2020 campaign. A group of Republican senators accused Fateh of quid pro quo, claiming the Minneapolis Democrat sponsored a $500,000 grant to Somali TV in exchange for free advertising on that YouTube channel.
No, there's no standard rate. Sometimes we negotiate.
But Somali TV President Syed Salah today backed up what he'd already said in a written affidavit that Fateh paid for his campaign ads and video production. The problem is Fateh used his own money and did not report it as a campaign expense at the time, something that's since been corrected.
That has been recognized by the campaign finance board.
The panel found no evidence of quid pro quo, but did agree Fateh should be ordered to get more campaign finance training.
Nothing sinister, so I just think that's important for us to remember.
The second complaint was that Fateh didn't respond when his brother-in-law, Musa Mahmoud Mohammed, was convicted of lying to a federal grand jury about ballots he turned in on behalf of other voters in 2020 without their permission.
So based on the advice of my lawyer, I'm again going to invoke my Fifth Amendment right and decline to answer.
Dawson Kimyon was Fateh's campaign manager, but took the Fifth Amendment repeatedly when asked about the campaign. Eventually, the panel dropped the second complaint, finding no evidence that Fateh knew about the ballot situation.
Now, the case now goes to the full Senate Rules Committee. It'll be up to them to decide whether or not to impose this proposed sanction against Senator Fateh, the sanction of more campaign finance training. That committee hasn't scheduled its next meeting. In St. Paul, John Cromer, KRLV News.